Factor trinomials, radicals, and fractional exponents. So now we're going to learn about how to use fractional exponents to do the same things that we've been doing with radicals. It's just a different way of rewriting the radical. So when we write it as a fractional exponent, the exponent becomes the numerator. Remember, the numerator is the number on top in a fraction. So the exponent becomes the numerator in the fractional exponent, and the index becomes the denominator, the number on bottom of the fraction in the fractional exponent. Okay, and then you want to remember to simplify the fractional exponents whenever possible. So we're going to simplify them by reducing the fractions. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at a couple of quick examples of how we can do this. So here we've got example one, simplify using fractional exponents. So I've got the fourth root of x to the 12th. So I can see from my notes up top that my exponent is going to become the numerator. And my index is going to become the denominator. So when I rewrite this as a fraction, I'll still have the x on bottom, and then I'll have a fractional exponent where the number on top will be 12, and the number on bottom, the denominator, will be 4. So now I want to simplify or reduce this fraction that's my new exponent. So I can see in this fraction, both the top and the bottom are divisible by 4. So when I go ahead and reduce that, I come up with x raised to the 3 over 1. And 3 divided by 1 is just a plain 3, so then I come up with x to the 3rd. So now we have completely simplified this expression, and that's our answer for example 1. Okay, so then looking at example 2, this one says write as a radical. So this one is talking about actually going back from having a fractional exponent into having a radical. So we're just going to go ahead, and this is our numerator. So the numerator is the same as the exponent on the radical, and the denominator is the same as the index on the radical. So now the 5 is still going to be our base, our argument at the bottom, and then I'm going to have a little 5 as the exponent, and I'll write my square root, and then I'll have this denominator, the 8, as my index. And that is how we can rewrite 5 raised to the 5/8 as a radical. Now let's take a look at example 3. So example 3 says simplify using fractional exponents. And we've got the third root of 64. So the first thing that I want to do here is actually break down my 64 and see whether or not I can come up with some number raised to an exponent. So I can use my rules about exponents. So I know 64 is 8 times 8. And then I can break each of those 8s down into 4 times 2. So in the end, I'm coming up with 2 6 times. So this is going to be the same thing as 2 raised to the 6th. Okay, so now I have an exponent to use as my numerator. And this index right here will be my denominator. So now I can rewrite this as 2 raised to the 6/3. And then to simplify this fraction, I'm seeing again that this is actually a 6 that's divisible by 3. So I can just divide that out, and I'll get 2 raised to the 2, or 2 squared, which is 2 times 2, or 4. So now we're able to use these fractional exponents to really easily come up with a simple answer for what the third root of 64 is. And that's our final answer.